Jim Croce.
Wow, it's a long way from North Dakota. Roy, that stock cowboy, he too much to believe. You know he always got an extra pack of cigarettes rolled up in his t-shirt sleeve. He's got a tattoo on his arm, I'll say baby. He's got another one to just say hey. But every Sunday afternoon he is a dirt track demon in his 50s of a Chevrolet. It is a rapid Roy, that stock cowboy, he's the best driver in the land. You know he said that he learned to race a stock car by running shine out of Alabama. You know the demolition derby and the figure eight is easy money in the bank compared to running from the man into Oklahoma City with a 500-gallon tank. And it's a rapid Roy, that stock car boy, he too much to believe. You know he always got an extra pack of cigarettes rolled up in his t-shirt sleeve. He's got a tattoo on his arm, I say, baby. He got another one and just say, hey. But every Sunday afternoon, he is a dirt track demon in his 50s of a Chevrolet. Take it, Chuck. Hey, Roy, so cool, that recent fool. He don't know what fear's about. He do 130 mile an hour, smiling at the camera with a toothpick in his mouth. Got a girl back home, name her Dixie Dawn, but he got honeys all along the way. And you ought to hear them screaming for the dirt track demon in his 50s of a Chevrolet. And it's a rapid Roy, that stock cowboy, he too much to believe. You know he always got an extra pack of cigarettes rolled up in his t-shirt sleeve. He's got a tattoo on his arm, we'll say baby. He's got another one and just say hey. But every Sunday afternoon he is a dirt track of himself a Chevrolet. Thank you. Thank you very much. You know, I remember it was a couple years ago, 3 years ago, when we were here, and like it's really been something, a couple of years in between, I get into doing a couple other things other than playing, just for character development, that have, a lot of songs have come out of. This is one that kind of came out of, I had a job working painting elevator shafts one time, which was really weird. Gig, he starts having weird dreams at night of hot dogs chasing donuts through the Lincoln Tunnel, you know, all these weird psychophallic dreams. But you know what happened? I got out of college after taking all these courses, 1965, totally prepared for life in the 12th century. So there wasn't much else I could do but do a lot of these weird gigs. And this is kind of a song that came out of that. The title's so long that it would be the whole thing by the time I got done saying it, so we'll just play it. Well, I had just got out from the county prison doing 90 days for non-support. try to find me an executive position. But no matter how smooth I talk, they wouldn't listen to the fact that I was a genius. The man said we got all that we can use. Now I got them steadily depressing, low down mind messing, working at the car wash blues. Well, I should be sitting in an air-conditioned office in a swivel chair, talking some trash to the secretary, saying, hey now mama, come on over here. But instead I'm stuck here rubbing these fenders with a rag and walking home in soggy old shoes. But with them steadily depressing, low down mind messing, working at the car wash blues. You know a man of my ability, he should be smoking on a big cigar. But till I get myself straight, I guess I'll just have to wait in my rubber suit rubbing these cars. Well, all I can do is to shake my head. You might not believe it is true, but working at this end on Niagara Falls is a undiscovered Howard Hughes. So baby, don't expect to see me with no double martini and in my highbrow society news. Cause I got them steadily depressing, low down mind messing, working at the car wash blues. Yeah, I got them steadily depressing, low down mind messing, working at the car wash blues.
Thank you. Oh, man. Whew.
Operator, well, could you help me place this call? I see the number on the matchbook is old and faded. She's living in L.A. with my best old ex-friend Ray. Gosh, she said she knew well and sometimes hated. Isn't there the way they say it goes? Let's forget all that and give me the number if you can't find it, so I can call just to tell them I'm fine and to show I've overcome the blow. I've learned to take it well. I only wish my words could just convince myself that it just wasn't real. That's not the way it feels. Operator, well, could you help me place this call? 'Cause I can't read the number that you just gave me. Something in my eyes, you know it happens every time. Think about the love that I thought would save me. But isn't there the way they say it goes? But let's forget all that and give me the number if you can't find it, so I can call just to tell them I'm fine and to show on the blow, learn to take it well. I only wish my words could just convince myself that it just wasn't real. But that's not the way it feels. No, 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 no. That's not the way it feels. Operator, oh, let's forget about this call. There's no one there I really wanted to talk to. thank you for your time. Oh, you've been so much more than kind. You can keep the dime. Isn't there the way they say it goes? Let's forget all that and give me the number if you can't find it, so I can call just to tell them I'm fine and to show. Overcome the blow, learn to take it well. I only wish my words could just convince myself that it just wasn't real. But that's not the way it feels. This is, I used to play in a lot of little country and western bars, kind of places with 3 and 4 chrome-plated pickup trucks out front of them, rifle rack in the back window. You ever seen those little places that sit off the side of the road with a big flickering beer sign? You go in, they have little pocket handkerchiefs inside of plastic bags, those little smoked fish hanging in bags. There's usually a girl with an ace bandage around her left leg, bleach blonde hair on top of her head, done up in honor of the Dairy Queen. Usually got a dip of snuff under this lip and some chewing gum back there. Doing all that at the same time, popping it and saying heavy things like, "Hiya, hon." But there's a rule about picking up girls like that, though. First place, up to 350 pounds, I figured, they're still a person. And around 400, they become a place. And you can't be messing with them in the summertime, you know, because it starts getting hot and you start getting slippery and slide off, get hung up in wrinkles. Am I there? Am I there? But this is an old country tune. Well, she walks right and she talks right and she knows what makes the girls feel fine. He's got a way with women, and he just got a way with mine. He drives a big car like a big star. He picks a guitar, that bluesy kind. He's got a way with women, and he just got a way with mine. Well, now he didn't come up in shining armor, riding on a milk-white steed. But I've never seen quite a performer, so I guess I'm gonna have to concede. That mother walks right, and he talks right, and he knows it makes the girls feel fine. He's got a way with women, and he just got a way with mine. But I've never seen quite a performer, so I guess I'm gonna have to concede. That mother walks right, he talks right, he knows it makes the girls feel fine. He's got a way with women, and he just got a way with mine. Thank you. I'd like to introduce the band. Really good friend of mine, great musician and songwriter, Mari Muleisen.
Hi, everybody. Thanks for being here. Hi.
It's all Ozark Airlines. Oh, someone else has taken the dread white knuckle flights. You know you're in trouble. They give you rosaries now when you get on. You go out and try to find where your plane is. They say it's the one leaning up against the box. The wicker seats in it. Said it was bound to happen. It's just a matter of time. But now I've come to my decision, and it's one of the painful kind. 'Cause now it seems that you wanted a martyr. Just a regular guy wouldn't do. And baby, I can't hang upon no lover's cross for you. Gotta hand it to you, girl, you really tried. But for every time that we spent laughing, there were two times that I cried. You were trying to make me your martyr. That's the one thing I just couldn't do. And baby, I can't hang upon no lover's cross for you. Tables are meant for turning, and people are bound to change. Bridges are meant for burning, when the people and memories, they join on the same. But I hope that you can find another who can take what I could not. He'll have to be a super guy, or maybe a super god. 'Cause I never was much of a martyr before, and I ain't about to start nothing new. And baby, I can't hang upon no lover's cross for you. 'Cause tables are meant for turning, and people are bound to bridges are meant for burning, when the people and memories, they join on the same. Still I hope that you can find another who can take what I could not. He'll have to be a super guy, or maybe a super god. 'Cause I never was much of a martyr before, and I ain't about to start nothing new. And baby, I can't hang upon no lover's cross for you. Thank you. You know, I think one of these days they're going to get all the truck stops and put little bronze plaques outside of them, make them into national shrines, because you really get to see some of the neatest people in the world hanging around some of these places, the roadway of Americas. Get to meet these guys that drive really long distance, like Seattle to Key West twice a week, or Portland, Maine to San Diego. They're talking some driving. You know, and those guys, in driving that far, come to realize real soon that it's impossible to do it on a natch. You know? So what they do, they stop at a lot of these truck stops and pick up... Yeah, we're going to get to it. What they do is they pick up these things that they call directional aids, second drivers, co-pilots. Yeah, and they get a little black one that they call the West Coast turnaround. You take in New York City and drive to L.A. and turn around and drive back all the time, talking to your windshield. And you can always tell, everyone thinks they're wearing mirrored sunglasses, but it's their eyeballs, you know? And they cut off a broomstick about this long and put one end on the throttle pedal and the other one against the seat. See, and this keeps the pedal down to the floor and gives them extra foot to dance with once they really get cooking. Yeah. That's the truth. See some of these guys. Just walking around like that. In fact, the last time we stopped in a truck stop on Route 202 and got talking to an old truck driver, and he told us a story about a guy that had driven a million miles, and a radio station came down to interview him, and they said, "Geez, could you tell us what it's like to drive a million miles?" He said, "Yeah." He turned a tape recorder on. He said, "I've seen just about everything. Jackknife, blown tires, had my brakes go." He says, "You name it, it's happened." I said, "Wow." He said, "Let me just set up a situation so you can tell the people out there in radio land how it feels to have these quick reactions. Suppose you're driving from L.A. to New York. You get in Colorado and you hit the first big peak in the Rockies and you see a sign that says two lanes, no guardrail, downhill 3 miles. Truckers use low, low gear." He says, "Uh-huh." Well, you start, you know, it's 2:30 in the morning. Your partner's crumbled up asleep on a seat next to you. Make it up over the top. About a quarter of a mile down, you tap on a brake. Nothing happens. He says, "Uh-huh." You make it around the first curve and that 40-footer just glides around behind you. He says, "Uh-huh." But you see around the next curve is a Volkswagen up on a jack, getting his back tire changed. He tilts his hat back and says, "Yeah." And coming up the other way, you see a fuel oil truck in low, low gear. He says, "Uh-huh." He says, "What would you do?" He said, "Well," he says, "I'd wake my partner up." He says, "Jesus, with all this going on, you'd wake your partner up. What would you do that for?" The guy looked at him and said, "Well, he ain't been driving long, and I know he ain't never seen a wreck like this before." That's truck drivers. This is Speedball Tucker. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4.
I drive a broke down rig on May 5 tires, 40 foot of overload. A lot of people say that I'm crazy because I don't know how to take it slow. I got a broomstick on the throttle. I got her open it right down. Non-stop back to Dallas, popping them West Coast turnarounds. Oh, and they call me Speedball, Speedball Tucker. Terror of the highway and all them other truckers. But there you'd have to poison, man. You'd be driving in a rig like that. But that don't bother old Speedball, he going any damn way he please. He got his broomstick on the throttle, to keep his throttle footer dancing round. But with a cup full of cold black coffee and a pocket full of West Coast turnarounds. Oh, and they call me Speedball, Speedball Tucker. Terror of the highway and all them other truckers will tell you that the boy is man. You'd be driving in a rig like that. I looked into my rearview mirror, and coming up from behind, there was a Georgia State policeman and $100 fine. Oh well, he looked me in the eye as he was riding me up. He said, "Driver, you been flying. 95 is the route you were on. It was not the speed limit sign." Oh, and they called me Speedball, Speedball Tucker. Terror of the highway and all them other truckers were there. You'd have to poison, man. You'd be driving in a rig like that. Yeah, they call me Speedball, Speedball Tucker. Terror of the highway and all them other truckers were there. You'd have to poison, man. You'd be driving in a rig like that.
This is a really old song, written by Robert Burns, as legend would have it. The man that gave us Ivanhoe, the cigarillo, and the cordless vibrator. It's really a very old tune about a party they had in Scotland. Back in the days when they used to all get together, huddle together for warmth, you know, pulled the drawbridge up in the castle and everything was cool. So somebody got some rosehip seeds. Now that's a very good natural source of vitamin C, but as they grow, they're really itchy. Now the girls, you got to have a picture of the big stone room, big walk-in fireplace, double cross swords over it, and a suit of armor with a rust stain down the leg. You wonder why they lost the Crusades. Their armor would freeze up. But anyhow, somebody get these rosehip seeds, and these are the days when girls are wearing the long billowy skirts with, they say, Ken underwear. That means no underwear. Throw these seeds on the ground, and as the fiddler's playing, the girls kick these seeds up underneath the dress. And inside of about 15 minutes, everybody's got the worst itch you can think of. They're up backing up against a cold stone wall and rubbing against it like a cat in heat. You know? And they're up doing that. Remember, this is a couple hundred years ago. And then somebody comes and dumps an aphrodisiac into the punch. A love potion. And this takes about 45 minutes to get everybody, but then the short neck disease sets in, which is boom. You see it in bars a lot. Who's it gonna be? You know? Who's gonna be the recipient of my long anticipated glee? Of course, they said it in Old English, you know. That was the idea behind it. So, next thing you know, there was this party, and an orgy started, and like the guy that taught me the song said, so what happened then, lad? Was an orgy of such great magnitude that 40 acres of corn were fucked completely flat. Each verse is a photograph. I might do a lot more of them tonight. 24 virgins come down from Inverness, and when the ball was over, there were 24 less. Singing a balls to your partner, your ass against the wall. If you've never been out on a Saturday night, you've never been out at all. It is Saturday night, and I can't see that many of you, you know. I won't be embarrassed. There was dewing in the parlor, there was dewing on the stones, but you couldn't hear the music for the wheezing and the groans. Singing the balls to your partner, your ass against the wall. If you've never been out on a Saturday night, you've never been out at all. The Undertaker, he was there, all wrapped up in a shroud, swinging from the chandelier and peeing on the crowd. Singing a balls to your partner, your ass against the wall. If you've never been out on a Saturday night, you've never been out at all. The village idiot, he was there, I can tell you that. He was amusing himself by abusing himself and catching it in his hat. Singing a balls to your partner, your ass against the wall. If you've never been out on a Saturday night, you've never been out at all. The village mayor, he was there out in the back, of course, hiding in the stable, just a jacket off a horse. Singing a balls to your partner, your ass against the wall. If you've never been out on a Saturday night, you've never been out at all. You know, there's an Australian version of that too, about there not being anything wrong with falling in love or making in love with sheep. They just say it's a long way around front for a kiss, you know. Young Mary McPherson was standing way up front with some posies in her hands and a carrot in her hand. Singing a balls to your partner, your ass against the wall. If you've never been out on a Saturday night, you've never been out at all. Okay, we'll do that. The village postman, he was there, but the poor man had the pox. He could not do the lassies, so he did the letterbox. Singing a balls to your partner, your ass against the wall. If you've never been out on a Saturday night, you've never been out at all. Here's one more verse about an idiot. There must have been a couple of them. The village idiot, he was there, he played the perfect fool. He sat beneath the oak tree and he whittled off his tool. Singing the balls to your partner, your ass against the wall. If you've never been out on a Saturday night, you've never been out at all. Oh, here's a neat one. The bishop had a broken leg, so he could not do much. So he lined the ladies against the wall and he did them with his crutch. Singing a balls to your partner, your ass against the wall. If you've never been out on a Saturday night, you've never been out at all. Now this is the mystical verse. This one you'll never forget. Stays locked and trapped somewhere in your mind. Anytime you feel kind of down and the weather's not right or something, just think about this verse. Someday I'm going to have a whole billboard of it made, put in the center of Philadelphia. Here it comes. I have a hard time getting through it sometimes. Just getting like Kreskin. Here we go. The village magician, he was there, he gave us all a laugh. He pulled his foreskin over his head and he vanished up his ass. Singing the balls to your body. Bad, bad, Leroy Brown. The baddest man in the whole damn town. Better than old King Kong. The meaner than a junkyard dog. Yes, he's bad, bad, bad,
bad, Leroy Brown.
The baddest man in the whole damn town. Better than old King Kong. Thank you very much.